drive time. I'm in my car. I'm driving far. Drive time.
Oh, okay. Did you see that ambulance going by? Oh, man. The car for me stopped. Oh, boy. What the fuck? Like, there's no need to stop. Alright, the camera. Alright, let me do the intro. Proper intro after that. Got preoccupied with the car in front of me coming to a complete stop in an open lane while the ambulance passed us, but it is Thursday, the 13th day of June 2013, so we got 13-13 going on. That happens every once a month, actually, this year. We have, what is it, raining now, and it's supposed to rain all the damn long day. All the day, damn day long. Into the night, even. So another just colossal amount of precip in this area. The last week we've been really soaked. The land has been soaked up by the Mother Nature's tears of joy. Yeah, it's cool though. You know, we haven't had to put the air AC units in the windows yet, so that's nice. That's nice. You know, not have to do that yet, because then that, you know, saves energy and you can get the fresh air still. But it's Thursday. It's 9:04 a.m. Eastern Standard. Yeah, kind of been running late recently. Whatever. I mean, it's not a big deal to say, like, I'm not going to get demerit. It's not how we roll. Or at my place of business. So the camera thing, the thing that's holding the thing that you're watching, video feed that you're taking in right now. I bought a spy cam on eBay for $9. And it came with like a bunch of little accessory clip-on things that you could mount it to. And the thing that I'm mounting it to the window, is one of the things. And I also had, not that didn't come with the spy cam, but I had a sticky adhesive two-sided thing for a hook that I didn't use the hook. So I just stuck the adhesive two-sided thing onto the windshield, and then I used Velcro to put on the back of the iPod Nano 5G, and then on the little base where the thing clipped into, on the holder thing. So it worked out well, but it's cheap, and now the angle that we're getting has been compromised because I used to be able to prop it out more so you could get more of the road and more of a straight ahead angle, and now it's upward tilted a little bit too much. I think I fixed it today. It's better than it was yesterday when it was mostly just, but you're still not getting as much of the straight ahead view of the road and cars coming at me as I would, you know, prefer, or would be ideal in my head. So I think we're gonna try and maybe rig it with some duct tape. I don't know. Eventually, we'll probably have to replace it because this thing probably only has a shelf life of X amount of episodes of the DT, you know? It's just a little bit too much weight for it. So we just spent a whole car ride talking about, again, just talking about how the camera of the thing we're watching. I didn't get any kind of good thoughts, and we're almost there. Jesus, this weather. One day it's beautiful, next day it's just, you're living in the Amazonian rainforest, you know? Yeah. When I get to this turn right here, that's when I'm like, I can't really, what do I talk about now? Because I'm just, like, get into anything, even if I have anything to get into, it's just gonna be over soon. We're almost there. It goes by in flash, don't it? life. It's life. I was thinking about the NSA thing, PRISM, and all this information leaks, and you know, obviously it's a big story. I'd probably have a different take on it than most people, or maybe what you would assume someone like me, whatever that means, would have. And that I prefer that they wouldn't do it, but I also just think it's hilarious in a way that, like, they, like, there's a thought that, okay, someone in a room somewhere is trying to make sense of the data of what I'm personally looking at. Like, what are people? So people are mad because their privacy is okay, but I also think it's just hilarious that there, you know, potentially could be a man or a woman working in some government fucking building with, like, no windows, and they're, like, looking at my internet history. Like, that is just, that's hilarious to me. I know people get really upset about it, because it's a breach, you know, but, like, I wonder, like, well, you know, what is there really to get upset about? I think it's funny. Like, I just think it's hilarious someone would be in that position and have to make sense of that. And it's too much. I know there's, like, they're working, they have algorithms, the whole thing, big data. I get that. There's a way to, like, take all this information and try and find, like I said, what are they looking for? Ne'er-do-wells? Some punks? I mean, maybe they're looking for terrorists? Red flags? Maybe I'm flagged. But what does that even mean? If I'm flagged my whole life just because they saw something they didn't like, I looked at the internet and I don't know about it, and nothing came of it, and I just lived my life the way I wanted to live my life. What, like, there's, you know, we're touching on certain boundaries of what concrete reality really is. Think about it. Yes, it's concrete reality that they have this data now, but what does that mean to me? I can't, this is a topic not for drive time, potentially.
Till the afternoon lunch break, alright.